very dim. She was.
Now, my husband,
good evening. This is our first digital competition of the year. I'm glad to see we have good participation. The library did extend our hours, so we are able to have the room till 8:30 now, so we're not quite as rushed as we feared we would be. Do we have any new members here, or visitors? Yeah, Gore Kennedy was here last meeting, but he did officially join. We got any other visitors or potential new members? Okay. I think we're going to go ahead and get started. I'll let Al introduce the judges. He has the names in the bio, so we'll let Al get going.
Okay. I'm very happy to have three judges that I've come to know over the last year or so, 2 years actually, and some more than that. let me start with Brad. Brad LaPayne is attached to lives around the corner from me. We're neighbors. And Brad LaPayne Photography is nationally known for his remarkable panoramic photography, his specialty since 1988. His photographs of events in Memorial Stadium and the Assembly Hall are found throughout our local area. He's shot many nationally important events, including the first night game at Wrigley Field, several NBA's final games, and six Rose Bowls. Some of his skyline photographs have appeared in movies and TV shows, including the movie Next of Kin. Do you remember that movie? It shows a photo of a Chicago skyline. His portfolio includes a very large selection of panoramic views of national parks, national state parks, especially in the western U.S. And he's been published in many newspapers and magazines, including the New York Times and Time Magazine. John Dixon, next to Brad, is retired from the News Gazette, where he was a photojournalist for more than 25 years.
Let's not split hairs.
Yeah. This is what you get. He began his career as a photo lab tech at the paper in 74 while in high school at Champaign Central, and became a full-time photographer in 79. He's won several awards for his work from the National Press Photographers Association, Illinois Press Photographers Association, Associated Press, and UPI. Some of his work has appeared in the national publications, including Time Magazine, The New York Times, Newsweek, U.S. News and World Report, and Sports Illustrated. And he's been published worldwide by the AP. And then Scott Paisley, his interest in photography goes back 4 decades. And when he was afforded the opportunity to pursue it professionally about 20 years ago, he began capturing images on assignment for Vintage Motorsport magazine. His career-long work in graphic design, art direction, and photo direction for the Divide, and as a freelance graphic designer, continuing to guide his eye for subject, composition, and lighting. His projects have ranged from print to video to fine art. His current list includes collector car auction companies, architecture firms, motorsport publications, the News Gazette, and the Divide. So we have three distinguished judges with us tonight. So, it'll be interesting to get their comments as we move through this photos.
One more quick comment, then we can go ahead and get started. I am videoing the meeting, and the members will get a YouTube link probably about a week from now, and this will have the full video of tonight's meeting. So, we're ready to get started.
Would you each hit the one button? It doesn't matter which one.
Any button?
I did. Each of you hit one button.
The third one.
Okay. There we go. Okay. The first category, which is bridges. And
oh.
Bridges and Boats.
Bridges and Boats, okay, has 19, has 19 images in it, and we will look at those images first. So I'm going to go through them fairly slowly here. And then we can begin voting. Choose a number between 1 and 5 on your number pad. If you press a number that's not one of those, we'll have to ask you to just vote again.
5 being the highest score?
5 is the highest, yes.
At the very end, what are we looking for in terms of acceptance and so forth?
Okay, because we have 2 for acceptance, otherwise known as honorable mention, we will have only 6 to 7 images out of the 19.
And how many places do we have, like, per second?
And there are 4 places, first through 4th. And then the remaining images are considered honorable mention. Okay, are we ready? That one's done. All right.
Nope.
Oops, I hit the wrong one.
Yep, hit the wrong one.
Sorry, have to do that again.
Can you put your scores in again, please?
It's all together. Okay, next. So we need only six or seven, and we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So we will need to eliminate some of the scores.
The 11, you mean?
No.
Yeah. Okay, so we will vote through these again. Did you want to do in and out or just?
Can we preview a little one more time?
We'll look through each of them before we start.
Are those just the 11s?
11 and up.
Okay.
We have 9.
9, there's 9.
9.
Yeah, there's 9.
I just can't count. Okay. There are 9. And we want only a maximum of 7. So back again.
So we do again out, or are we voting with numbers again?
Well, what would you prefer? In and out is fine.
Or you could do numbers.
It's
already set up to do numbers.
It's set up to do numbers, but I can change it in and out.
We'll do numbers.
We'll do numbers.
Do numbers. Okay, very good.
Just kind of change the criteria.
Thank you. You're quick. Okay, so I'm going to have to let you have a look at them. We are ready to vote with a number.
What was that? I wasn't watching.
Well, the total was 10 on the
10,
phone.
Okay.
It was 10.
Oh, I can't.
Nobody's reading the numbers. Okay.
8.
Okay. Is it set on?
9. 10. 12. 13. 10. 10. 13.
3, 4, 5, 6, 7?
Yep.
10 and up is 7.
Yep, 10 and up, 7.
7, yeah.
Okay, now, we have 7, and you need to decide which 4 are the top 4, and first place, second place, third place, and fourth place.
So we just need to pick one of the 10s for...
The other 2, they are ATM.
So we need to put ATM, yeah, 4, ATM. ATM.
Where?
Right there. Clutter, yeah. I've got ATM. And then the one below.
Oh, okay, so we're doing all of the ones that are already chosen.
Just, yeah, click that, and you can... So then now you can go back and go back to the, over here, and then unclick all the way to the side where the boxes are at.
Yeah, they disappear.
So you can unclick those, because we weren't at awards on, so you can unclick the 6 and 3. And then you can see these again. Well, so they can start putting awards on.
They can look for the top 4 out of those, and the remaining ones, okay, I'm with you.
So if you want to do another score, if you want to do an analysis, or if they just want to look at them.
Okay.
Decide that.
Gentlemen,
Yes.
we can look at them, and you can just discuss them and decide, or we can do an in and out type vote.
Looks like the top 2.
I'd like to discuss them, I think.
Okay.
We're going to decide between the top 2, the top 3, actually, and then find 4.
Decide which one of the 10 you like the best.
You're telling me you might have to...
Yeah, this is like, it's tricky, I mean, they're not going to the score, right? But you can do that, just so you can look at the end, so...
All right, okay.
It'll almost be that we can see that.
Right, I'll go through.
Yeah, all together.
All together, is it possible to see them?
Yeah, I know, that's one thing I haven't figured out yet.
Not all of them. When we get down to 4, I might be able to go into another thing to do the 4.
My top 2 are this one and the road leading to the bridge.
The bridge, I agree.
And I love the whimsical part of this.
Yeah.
This one?
That one.
There's that one. I'll go through them slowly, and y'all can...
And my top 2 are the bridge and the road, but I like the bridge, that one better than the others.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay.
I like...
So the 4 side of the long lines, and cross it. That one, that's my 3.
They cropped it, I like that.
Yeah.
I like the whimsical nature of that. This one's arguably my first, and I can go with the bridge, they're both like, I like both of them.
I think I prefer this one over the bridge.
Yeah.
Be my number 1.
Which bridge?
The road leading to the bridge.
Okay.
Yeah, it's a toss-up for me, but those 2.
This is number 1 now?
Cover bridge 2?
That, I could easily do that.
Okay.
So number 1?
Number 1.
All right. So you got that one, Mary?
19, over there, Mary.
Sale of 4, sale of 4, number 1.
Okay.
The market, and then...
8389, or something like that, okay.
And then what's...
Number 1.
Yeah.
The other one?
What the projector, you know, what it's going to do.
Yeah.
Now, this one, was this your number 2?
Number 2.
Yes.
Number 2, Mary, it's covered bridge.
Okay.
I'd like to see a little less of this rock.
I like the whimsical nature of that.
Yeah.
This one's not doing a lot for me.
No.
It
There's a nice picture.
It's a nice picture.
I'm gonna go back to the, that's my next one.
Yeah.
I would say, I mean, I really like this one too, but I like the virtual better.
That one?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I would put that as three.
Number three?
We agree.
Sure, John, are you gonna? You gotta go to me.
Number three, Blooming Bridge.
Okay.
Four would be this one or the other, the guy taking the picture of the ship, so let's look at those two.
Yep.
They're both, I like them both.
Yeah, I do.
Yeah.
Are we in focus as tight as we can get it, or?
Looks in focus, but yeah.
Yeah, this looks like a little.
Maybe it's, I think it's like glasses fogged. I think I'd go with the other quote.
This one?
I like that one.
They can both use cropping.
Yeah.
If you could get down to the rocks right above the boat.
Or
even just below the bright green branches and then under the roof of the shed.
And we could tighten it up on the backside.
Yeah.
Leave a little more in the front side, on the bow.
The light is nice.
The light's great.
And the composition is real close.
We'll stick with that.
Yeah.
So number three?
Three.
Number four.
Four, I mean, yeah.
Four, I'm sorry.
Four, Something at Work, I can see that.
The remaining two.
Lobsterman.
Lobsterman?
This one, I guess is.
That's three, yeah.
Three.
Did you get number four, Mary?
Number four is.
Lobsterman at Work.
Number 10.
Image 10.
It's hard to see over here. Lobsterman Work. Okay, that's number four.
Yes.
Okay.
What's that phrase you like to use, John? Talk to content?
Yes.
Move the bird.
Yeah, move the bird.
So.
Okay. But.
So we got one.
Okay. So the others are HMs?
Yes, all the others are HMs.
Okay, so let me make sure I got them then.
Let's go back.
Rockport Fleet. That's an HM?
Yes.
Sailfin Regatta?
Yep.
Right.
That's an HM. And.
I can go through them numerically.
Photo op?
Hmm?
Photo op?
Photo op, yes.
Yes.
Okay. Is that all?
Did you get the other two there with the HMs on? What's that on here? Image number.
Seven, I've got all together. Three HMs and 1, 2, 3, 4.
Yeah, that's right.
Okay.
So she get the fishing boats or whatever, fishing boats, something that you have highlighted?
Yeah.
Did you get that one as an HM, Mary?
Which one?
The one that's highlighted up here?
Smith's Island. That one's not, is it?
Yeah.
Sailfin.
Smith's Island Fishing Boats. A170.
A170?
Yeah.
That was.
That's an HM. That was an 11. Score is 11.
It was a score of 11. But after you, so you want the ones that were in.
That was in the top third.
That were out.
Yeah. Is that
okay,
right?
So.
Right. Yeah, that's right. Yeah.
That would be the one you just mentioned, the two that were out. Which is Midland?
Yes.
Ridge? Yeah. Okay, so that's an HM too.
Yep.
Okay.
All right.
Okie doke.
Do you want to go through them and.
Okay.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Go through them and get the judge's comments maybe.
Okay. So what was the four of the regatta?
We have an hour and a half.
You can't just click them. You have to go to the end of the thing. You have to go back and start voting. And then you just scroll through the ones that were placed first, second, fourth.
Do you want me to read the names, or?
Yeah, when you, yes, when we get to it, when we get to the image.
Okay.
So, Chairman, Blooming Bridge, was it a?
It was third.
Third.
Blooming Bridge by Kim. Where did you find that Blooming Bridge?
Where did we find that bridge? Do you remember?
It was the one.
Yeah.
I was with you on the way back from Swimsy.
Yeah, that's
yeah,
right.
Yeah, okay.
I thought you'd recognize
it. It looked like that bridge, but
this one was fourth, right?
It was in some little town, right?
Yeah, it was somewhere, you dragged me somewhere and off somewhere and we found it, yeah.
Yeah, we went to look for something else and found that bridge.
So, yeah, and then this one was fourth?
Yes.
Here's a, this is Ray's, and it's Lobsterman At Work. Yay!
Are you looking for conversation about this?
Yeah, sure, sure.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, let's go back to Blooming Bridge.
Blooming Bridge, go back to Blooming Bridge.
All right.
I think you've done a good job with composition. I might have cropped it a little higher up from the bottom, just to bring the flowers. Again, I'm a crop to content guy, as you heard, and I think you might, I'm just looking for my hands right now, you know, from the bottom of the flowers, and then to the greenery.
It's a little out of symmetry.
But the harder I tried to make things symmetrical, the worse they got.
Sometimes that happens. Sometimes
it's a nice picture.
Yeah.
Sure, we'd love to see streaming light from one side or the other. But that wasn't the time of day you were there, or it looked like it was probably cloudy.
It looks like cloudy.
But you did the best with what you had. I might crop it just a smidge more.
Yeah. Actually, I would have taken it off the top, John.
Mm-hmm. Down to the greenery there.
Yeah, mm-hmm.
Yep.
Okay, thank you. This guy, any comments?
And I really like the light on this. This has got the light that the other one didn't have. But then again, I'm using my hands, and I'm just trying to get below that. You know, my eye gets drawn to that white line of the shed.
Yeah.
It's not necessary. Get rid of it.
Yeah, cut it out.
Get it out of here. I want to see the bird and the wall and the boat and the water.
It's got a lot of horizontal lines. You know, the water line, the top of the boat, the shoreline, and there's a line of rocks, and then that shed and the house have got vertical horizontal lines as well. Brought it clear down to the lawn, just where you get the lightness of the top of the grass, where the grass is lit.
It would be perfect if the stone wall was 5 feet high.
Yeah.
We can do everything.
Yeah, so you needed to build the stone wall up, right?
Yes.
And it would have been nice maybe to see some more reflection in the water. The lighting really nicely isolates the subject.
Makes the subject stand out. Yeah. And this one's all composition. I Scott said he could have used a little less rock, and I'm sure
less of the big rock and more of the little rocks.
I'm sure you were going for the fence post over there too.
Yeah.
But nicely done. The road takes your eye. You know, it feels like you can walk that path right to the bridge. I like the composition.
Yeah, I like the curve. Where is the bridge?
This is Covered Bridge by Charles.
Yeah, but where is it?
Which bridge is it?
It's up there in the top.
No,
it's
there.
It's in Indiana.
Among the 50 that are in Indiana.
Yeah, all right.
This was an honorable mention.
Yeah.
Yep.
And it's Sailfin Regatta by Al Wehrmann.
Yeah.
Oh, the one before that was.
I assume it was the foresight because you had to kind of wait to get that position.
Who's this one?
Okay, this one is this photo op?
This is Sail.
By Kim.
Sailfin Regatta.
Okay.
Oh, back to the, Sailfin Regatta by Al Wehrmann.
So imagine this, I think it was Al's voice earlier that said, crop the content. And they have.
Even tighter.
You can see how there's water way above this and there's water way below this, and it would have just been a lot of water. Brought it down to the content and made a nice crop out of it and made an interesting picture.
I do like that you took took a pretty severe crop on it.
Yeah.
It took a little bit of courage.
Yep.
Okay.
This is photo op.
Photo op by Kim. On the way back from swimming.
Yeah, took the same trip.
Yeah.
It's a whimsical photo. I like the, you know, photographer. Look, I think it's a photographer. I don't think it's a picture.
Yeah, he's got both hands up to his eyes. Yeah. I would assume it's, he's taking a picture or he's looking at the boat with a pair of binoculars.
Or he's bracing for impact.
Yeah, and you know, it, again, I'm a cropper, so I could have gone down. I'd like to have seen it crop down to the top of the red stack, and just give the red stack a little air, get rid of that round dish at the top that's kind of drawn my eye up, and maybe come into the structure on the right side of the boat, so there's there's nothing over there. Get rid of it. It's a line now that I'm staring at.
Yeah, I kind of want to see one end or the other of the boat. Mm-hmm. Crop off.
Right. Yeah. I was just going to say you could crop off the left as well.
Yeah.
Either way, maybe leave it, give it a little space so you can see where it's going, and not necessarily.
But I think the photographer's trying to keep the
focus.
Kayak out of the middle, which is a great thing. So they, you know, it's what you've got to work with. We're sitting here second guessing it, and if we do what I want, we're probably going to put the kayaker right in the middle, and I'm going to say, rule of thirds, move the kayaker.
Move the kayaker.
All right.
Okay.
And this is Sales of Four by Kim.
Number one.
What was your focal length on that lens? Do you remember?
The focal length? I have no idea.
Okay. I don't think it shows in this program.
Except you had to walk out a long pier to get
there. Yeah, it was a long pier. I don't know. Remember if they were.
It's pretty long.
Yeah, it looks like it's long enough that the human on the left side looks a little distorted, even. The tall person standing on the ship. But it's, you know, the sails are full of wind. I like the monochromatic feel of it, which is unusual. Usually we want to see bright colors and dramatic light, and this doesn't have that, but it's got great composition. The horizon is level, and it just is one of those intangible things. Why I like it, I can't tell you. I think
I can put it in words. I really like that really severe horizontal of the horizon, and the curved sails. I really like that.
Yep.
Windows and doors. And there are 19 of them?
There are 19. We are in about the same count on each one of these.
And this is an open category, 19, right?
Yeah, it's an open category, so manipulation is okay.
Severe.
And I'm sorry, what's your definition of manipulation? They can change colors
anything,
or drag it around.
Anything goes.
And I'm sorry, the whole contest is an inter-club contest, or this is just this club?
Just our club.
Okay. I thought it was a multiple club.
Okay.
Yeah, next May we have a multiple club.
All right.
Okay, these I will go through in a little bit of time. Just a little.
What you making here?
Eight. Eleven. 9. Fourteen. Thirteen. Nine. Eleven. 9, 12, 13, 11, 10. Nine, 11, 10. Twelve, 11. 12.
Okay, that's 12.
We have 7 that are 12 and above, is that right?
Right, so go with that, go with that, so I'm going to go with the top third. Okay, I guess we're ready to look at them.
score again if you want, or you can just talk about it. We're only seven, but there's only seven to go.
Oh, do we have seven?
Yeah.
For 1, 2, 3, 4, and the rest?
Yeah.
Well, let's go through one more time, please. I'm kind of torn here that I like the barn again.
Yeah.
1, 2, 3, 4 fall somewhere between the last three images and the frosty photo.
I don't like this vertical net.
Yeah.
It cuts the edge off.
Yeah.
Like if you cropped it there and then it gets square, which it might be squares, but with that then it gets a little.
But you could, again, it's always hard to lose what you love and then it's on the stand up. I can't reach that. But if you want to accept, we're saying, you know, we're going to get rid of this, right? We're going to get rid of that. But if you did, what do you, you don't want a perfectly square front.
Yeah, then you end up with a square.
Something's got to go, and something can go from the top.
See, I think that
something can go from the bottom of it. And then you're not square again.
Yep. Yeah. I think I slightly prefer the other window.
Yes.
Since this one, I mean, since you can do manipulation, if you just took that out in Photoshop and clone and whatever it is, you'd solve the problem.
Yeah.
Yeah. We go to the next window, that one. Yeah, I really like that one.
I do. I love the light in it, but again, my eye goes right to the top where that dang corner is. I don't know. Maybe it's good because it's shadow, but want to see it gone now? Maybe it's three-dimensional. I guess I do like it.
Yeah. I think it does give you some dimension.
Yep. It's too flat if you take it out.
That's my top pick. It's kind of cool that you got the one window and then you've got the second window all the way up here in the corner.
Now I'm liking the shadow at the top and the bottom.
Yeah. I think it needs it.
Yeah, it does. It would be too bland without.
There's a whole lot of these I just want to straighten just slightly.
I like that. That's 1, 2, 3, or 4. I don't know which yet.
That'd be one for me.
All right. Let's move on. I like it, but it needs something.
Yeah. I can't quite say why.
It needs lighting or something. You know, it needs a dramatic light on one side.
Yeah. It's unremarkable land lighting.
Right.
But it's still interesting.
Mm-hmm. It's a cute window.
And this, I like. I want to see some shadow detail.
Yes,
in a flat day, but I like the windows. I mean,
yeah.
It hits the, you know, you've got a door and a couple of windows, just a lot of nice, interesting.
And it's the action. It's nice.
Gray, and there's some spots of color. The pink bench is a nice touch.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
Next. I like to think of this.
It's eye-catching. I like it. I don't know where it falls yet, but it's up there. If it's windows and doors, this says windows and windows.
But it's kind of cool because you've got a lot of different layers there. It's
yeah.
At least three buildings there.
Yeah.
And, you know, it's obviously not the United States.
It's very European looking.
Yep.
And again, I hate to keep doing it, but I would
crop out
to the right. I'd go to that, you know, I want to see that steeple, that far steeple on the right. I don't want to see whatever that is at the top.
Oh.
Okay.
It's kind of giving me vertigo.
Yeah. In a good way.
Yeah, no, it's really interesting. And monochromatic is kind of cool.
Mm-hmm.
And this one I definitely wanted to see straightened a little bit.
Yeah,
that's driving me crazy.
We're harping on
crops over there.
Yeah. It's the And it's, why is that wood there? I don't know. I don't know what it's got to do with it.
The white birch trees.
Yeah. But then there's a head at the bottom. Doggone it. Get rid of it. It's not doing anything.
Well, and since you can do vertical, you can do manipulation, it'd be easy to clone the black, get rid of the wood, and the head at the bottom, maybe have
just
crop.
You could just crop that right out, and it wouldn't change anything. But, and then, while you're at it, straighten it.
But you've got an interesting image here. I'm not trying to be too critical. I just want to say that head has got to go. That bugs me. When I saw that, I'm like, why didn't we crop that out?
Yeah.
We can argue about the wood on the right, but the head's got to go.
Off of the head. Off the head, yeah.
Okay, so what's that leave us with? I think I'm back to your number one window. I like that. Maybe all of the European window buildings, number two.
Okay.
That's number one, yeah.
I think my top three are this one, the other window, and the barn, and the weathered wood shed, whatever it is.
I can go with that.
Mm-hmm.
One.
So number one?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Number one, morning light.
Morning light?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
I really like that.
It's an honorable mention.
HM.
Okay, HM. Towels Pueblo window.
Towels Pueblo window. HM. Okay.
Two or three?
Mm-hmm. Three, what are we doing with the frosty window? I'd say it's between frosty window and the shed for three and four.
Did you mean the colorful frosty window?
No, I meant this frosty window.
Okay.
That was the wet window.
I like the shed for three.
Okay, I like the shed for three.
Yes, agree.
Third place?
Three, mm-hmm. Yes.
Third.
Have a look.
Have a look.
Okay.
And then this one.
Four.
Fourth.
Four.
Yes.
The frost.
The frost.
And we don't have a number two yet.
It's coming up.
Okay.
It's the European looking, I think. It's the European looking.
All the windows.
All the windows.
And the ceilings. Roof line.
Yep.
Roof lines.
Number two.
All the crazy angles. It's an interesting picture.
So it doesn't sound like you're sold on this guy.
I'm coming around.
Well, let's not shortchange the other one. The other, go one more, please. No, I'm sorry.
Two more.
There it is.
Oh, not definitely not that.
Okay, so I don't know what other one could be number two.
The wet window I liked, but.
Oh, back here.
Yeah, the first one.
This one.
I don't like I said, I wish it. That one got photoshopped, but it didn't.
Yeah, I'll go back to the European roof line.
Okay.
Vertigo and do
this one.
Vertigo and
do. I think I would have liked to move just a little to the right so that big dormer in the front got more in between the two dormers and back so that you didn't obscure it.
There's a whole lot going on, and when you try to crop that, you make the best decision.
So this is number two?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Windows everywhere?
Yeah.
Appropriately named.
Aptly named, yeah.
At every level.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay, so I need, we can just leave it up. Can we get them all?
Wingspread home is an HM.
Now, you don't have to make them an HM, but they just don't.
Oh.
I mean, if you don't want to make the...
No, I think that was fine.
Yeah.
They all rose above.
Okay,
and then there's another one. My window.
Yeah, my window is.
Is an HM too?
Yep.
Okay.
Morning light is number one, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Frost was four, I think.
Well, yeah, it was
three.
Four.
And the shed was?
Three. three.
Have a look, it's three. Okay. Eye candy.
Which one's two?
Windows, windows everywhere.
All right, you wanna display them, then we can.
We look at the bottom.
Yeah, you wanna go down.
We should look at them one more time, I think.
There you go, talk a little more.
Look at them one more time. Okay. This was number one.
Number one.
Number one is by Rita, and it's called Morning Light.
Who did that one?
Rita.
Rita.
Oh. Do we want just places or agents?
Do you wanna talk about it?
Yeah, let's talk about it.
Go back and talk about it.
Again, I think we just found the composition and lighting striking compared to the other images here, and it's.
I like the warmth of the window frame is, and the color of the walls.
And the color of the wall, right.
That's, there's a lot to like there.
Okay, so, this one's HM.
HM, Taos Pueblo Window by Tom Frey. Go back.
Go back.
And there's a lot to like here, it's time of day and lighting, and if, you know, if that's what you happen to walk by the window, and you're in your car and you're on your way, it looks like it's probably noon or 1 o'clock, I don't know, but it's just a picture that needs a dramatic light from one side or the other, there's, you know, the wooden framework of that window would just pop out, and then there's bars behind there, and it would all, and the nice color, it would work.
It's the color.
Just the lighting that's just not quite there.
The teal of the, that kind of crude wood frame and the warmth of the stucco, I really like that. But it is, the lighting is not quite doing it justice.
Okay.
Have a look.
Have a look.
How can you not name this eye candy?
I would call it a gas pump.
Have a look by Martha Compton.
It's nicely cropped.
Yeah.
It's the beautiful old gray building. It's all the crustiness of the benches and the gas dispenser.
The old gas.
Yeah.
You see the flag in the window on the
yeah.
side of the stuff.
A little bit of a color pop there.
Yeah. But there's a lot to like in this too.
Yeah.
The heart.
It's cropped tight.
That's,
yeah, it is.
It's just about where you want to.
Got rid of a lot of things we didn't need to see and showed us what she wanted us, or she wanted. Yeah. I have no idea who her. Sorry, I wanted us to see that.
Nice.
That's what they gave.
Good job.
Nice.
Yeah. Nicely done.
Okay. Next.
Okay. The Frost by Rosa. Number four.
And it's a good composition. There's no bright colors. It's just selling itself on composition and the monochromatic effect that's there, and the crustiness of that old window and the crystals on the on the glass.
Isn't it interesting that when we had just one bar in the other photo, we all scored it down, but now we
right.
have two.
But it's
got thirds.
It's the position of the frame.
I like a triptych. Yeah.
You know, it's got interesting detail. It's very subtle on the bottom, you know, where the just inside the glass, and then you've got a black, and then there's gray, and then there's black.
Yeah, and if this were a print, I would say it's really well printed. We've got highlights that aren't blown out, we've got shadows that aren't totally black, detail in midtones, detail in the shadows. It's nicely done.
Yep.
Yeah. And it looks better when your glasses are.
Yeah, it looks better when you take your glasses.
Windows, windows, windows everywhere by Rita. Number two.
I know what it is. I want to see a little bit of cloud, a little bit of detail.
Yeah, some sky detail.
Just a little.
Some of just a, whatever, pale blue sky with just the wispy clouds.
Or even if it was black and white, but just something other than solid, even white.
I like the gray. I just want to see it cropped. It's real close. I'm looking again, my eye goes up to that right-hand corner. It's not a steeple, it's not, it is a window, I guess.
Yeah.
But it's one window that we could do without, and then if we can manipulate these, get rid of that spotlight somehow.
Oh, yeah, right.
It's an interplay, put a sky or shoot.
Yeah, whatever, but the steeples are the accent to the windows, and it's just the one window over there that's kind of driving me buggers.
Rita, where is it?
It's in Quebec City.
Okay, that must be a lot of hills.
Yes.
That one building is this one.
Wasn't France, but it's almost France, kind of.
Yeah.
And this one is, this Wingspread Home by Jim McInerney? No?
Yes.
Yep?
Yeah.
I mean, I like all the lines and stuff, but, we've talked about the things that we don't like, and everything else is pretty nice.
The thing that works really well for me are the angular windows and the light there. I would have lost almost all the brick on this side.
Yep, and then come up to the bottom almost.
That little hint of the blue and the gold tones, I think that really would work.
And then, can you imagine that with a dramatic light from the left?
Yeah.
Can you imagine the patterns that would be in there?
Yeah, that would be something else.
The staircase, all the light from those windows, and maybe we'd then be criticizing it because it was too contrasty, but there's a lot of good things going on.
Yeah. Except for the hair.
Yeah, the head.
I can't figure out why there would be birch logs in there.
I can't either.
Okay, Carolyn?
That was that old, yeah, we should do that. Who that was?
It was Jim McInerney. Yeah.
Okay. All right.
Animals.
Now we are to.
Mary, do you want to read the guidelines on that?
Oh, I don't have it, but it includes pets. And does anybody have a copy of the description of fauna?
Well, in this case, fauna was any fauna.
Any fauna, it doesn't have to be.
Including bugs and.
Nature kind of fauna.
Domestic and wild.
Livestock, I don't know.
Yeah, domestic included, yeah.
Including pets. Important.
We were very open with our fauna.
We'll all see.
That's good.
That's why.
Yeah, that's why I was going down.
How many entries?
There are 24, so we need 8.
Right.
So it could be 4 places and 4 honorable mentions, or anyway, 4 places.
Okay.
Yeah,
8. We will go through these. are ready. Check.
Ten. Seven. Eight. Nine. Eight. Ten. Twelve. Eight. Eight. Nine. Eleven. Seven. Eleven. Eleven. Twelve. Ten. Ten. Fourteen. Thirteen. 12, 11, 11, 7, 9,
your club.
we do seven. We get away with it, but whatever you think. Above the seven. We have then about seven creditors for the next stack. So I would say let's just spend.
Where are you getting seven?
Where am I getting seven?
You've got them mixed.
Score one.
No, you've got the categories mixed.
Well, you got a hit category.
Oh, did I? Oh,
yeah.
That's a hit category.
Sorry,
there.
There we go.
Yeah, now I get. Let's go.
Oh, it's three. Ten. So we can vote out some of the 11s.
Yeah, that's what I get.
Five 11s.
Or just consider them all.
With all the 11s.
Yeah, that worked.
Okay, so, these are, two and maybe vote on the top ones. Do you want to maybe do in and out since we have 10? Or do you want to just vote again? By number?
Vote again.
Yeah, let's just vote again.
Vote again by number.
We can't remember what we got.
All right, sounds good.
So. Let's, let me go through them for you.
Thirteen. Nine. Eleven. Ten. Twelve. 15, 14, 12, 10, 10.
The category. There you go.
Can we throw in the number 11?
11.
Yeah. I don't know what the number 11 photo is, but
it's the dolphins. Four plus.
Yeah.
Let's,
okay.
Let's talk about it. Maybe it's
four
plus
okay,
two.
We're on those. Let me uncheck the two tens here. So, Mary, do you have those two?
So these are ATMs.
ATMs.
What's an ATM?
The saving, scanning Siegel.
What was the score? Sorry.
I should probably read over here.
Soaring Seagull was a 10.
Oh, okay.
So that's an HM.
Okay, HM.
And then the Snow White.
Snow Level? Leopard?
No.
Snow White, Seven Dwarfs.
Oh.
That's an HM.
Okay.
And the Snow Leopard, yeah, is an HM too. What? Wait, wait.
He's a 10 too.
Oh, no, we just want the 10s, right?
Yes, the 10s.
Yeah, Snow Leopard's a 10, yep.
Oh, yeah, okay.
What about feet first?
Feet first was a...
Oh, that was...
It was a 9, wasn't it?
Was
it
was a 9,
so
that okay.
Was 9.
No.
So we should have 11.
Okay, so we have five to choose four places?
Yeah.
You mean?
Yeah, we have.
We have six.
Six to get four places. Okay, so we're back to voting options, let's go. Do you want to do in and out or just discuss?
Six.
Let's just discuss in the way we have.
They're just going to talk, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so whatever you want to go. All right, so I'll go through them.
This is one. I really liked that except until I saw the kid.
I'm sorry, were you talking about this or that?
Yeah, I think the other, for me, the other dog does it. It's the background there. I'm cute, love the dog.
It's more.
And it's, without the kid, it's really got it going. And could have been able to crop it a little tighter without the kid.
You get what you get. That was my dog. I really like the picture.
Yeah. And the same old frog. If this was my frog, I would have really.
Yeah. I think we all like the frog.
Again, I wanted to crop it a little tighter, get rid of some of the black, the pointless black in the corner.
Some black is good, but
a little,
that's,
yeah,
that's quite a bit.
That's a lot.
The frog just jumps out of the photo. The colors are spectacular. But is there any argument that that's our number one? It scored the highest in all the voting.
Yeah,
number one.
So okay. Night Watchman.
Night Watchman. Yeah.
The Watchman.
Yeah.
Well, you just can't go wrong with the frog.
No.
Not with big red eyes.
Not big red eyes. Yellow toes.
Yeah, it's a really pretty picture. This is a pretty picture too.
Yeah, it's a nice photo.
It'd be tough to get that one too, I would suspect.
But I don't know if you're at the zoo or if you're. And it's hard to.
It looks like it's in the wild, but
I don't know.
It might not be. Is that a deer or like a?
It's some sort
some
of
kind
a
of little animal.
Gazelle thing.
Yeah, I thought it was a deer, but now that I'm looking at it, it doesn't look quite.
And the stripes are different.
Yeah, because the deer is more spotty rather than striping.
I saw one today in the golf course.
Yeah.
Yeah, so
it's like it's got a football field painted on its back.
Yeah.
Yeah. Photoshop.
I like this photo. It's different, I think it's because everything else except for the frog has fur.
Yeah.
But it's got good composition.
That the field works.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Great color.
Yep. I can crop it just a little
tighter. You can crop it a little tighter. Decent crop though.
There's something I like about the dolphin photo.
I like the dolphin photo. It's
like a painting.
It's like a painting. Again, I would crop a little bit off the top. And maybe, off the top. But it's.
There's something about it, the movement of the photo. Draws me into it. I think it's interesting.
It gives you the fluid, the thought that they're moving.
Yeah, it's like they're swimming in jello. It's green jello, it looks like. It's very thick.
As a matter of fact, it works.
So is that's everything we've got then. Go back through it one last time.
So we know the number one.
Number one.